Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how I sketched this portrait of Black Widow Scarlett Johansson. If you guys aren't aware on how to make outline of any pictures, I've posted an exclusive video on how to make use of grid lines to make accurate outlines, which will be very helpful for making such portraits. I'll leave the link in the description box below. Feel free to have a look at it. Let's get started with the shading. I personally like to start with the eyes as it instantly gives so much life to the picture. I start shading with an HB pencil followed by 2B and 4B for the pupil. I prefer using a 4B or any darker shade for dark areas and HB or any hard pencil for lighter areas. I'm using a white eraser pencil from the brand called as Kohinoor to make highlights. I keep adding layers of light to dark shades. Once I'm done with the iris, I move on to the lashes. I make use of blending stump, which helps me smoothen out the texture, resulting in a smooth skin-like surface. Don't refrain from adding darker shade as it pops out the eye really well. Mix of shadows, cast shadows, highlights and midtones gives very realistic results. You can also make use of brush if you don't have a stump to achieve this real smooth skin-like texture. It is all about creating the same what you see in your reference picture. The upper lid of the eye is usually darker as it shows the depth of the eye. So make the upper lid and the crease of the eye really dark. Here I am making use of 4B pencil to achieve that real darkness. The white part of the eye is never pure white. So ensure to give that little minimal shading to the white area, which will make it really look natural. Once you finish shading the eye, move on to the eyebrow and make nice strokes. Go with the flow of the eyebrows and do not leave any white space. Fill it with the layers following the contour shading. Darken up few strands and highlight some to make it feel the dense. Here I'm using 9B pencil from Caran d'Ache to darken up the strands as I want them really dark and stand out from the remaining area. You can also use Mono Zero eraser, Derwent electric eraser, or there are so many erasers in the market to make those white highlights. Now move on to the other eye and repeat the same process what you did for the right eye. It would be a better practice for you if you get your free time. Try to practice again and again, as eyes are the most important feature on a portrait. While you're drawing the other eye, just be careful while placing your fingers and do not smudge or erase the completed one on the right side. It is always advisable to use a paper or chart sheet or any thicker sheets beneath your hand, preventing the shade from getting spoiled. At this stage, you can see that we have created eye that looks real, which looks much thicker and deeper. Add more darker shade to the tear line for women, as they have mascara and kajal. I'm just trying to add more darker tones around the eyes. And now let me try to add some lashes. In the reference picture that I'm referring to, she had thick mascara put on. So I'm trying to make the lashes really dark and thick using my 4B pencil. Now you can see that the eye looks really attractive with dense mascara lashes. Once you got your eyelashes done, you can try experimenting with brush to observe how the graphite spreads evenly. I also use so many different mechanical pencils for the places like eyebrows, lashes and hair where minute attention is needed. The eyes have started to pop off really well at this stage. Now let's get started with the nose. Here you can see that I'm not making any stubborn or harder strokes for nose. I just prefer shading really gradual to make up the shape. I simply add strong cast shadows to make the nose highlight and give the depth of having it popped out of the cheeks. The nose holes need to be extremely dark along with the shadow of the holes. You could see that I'm adding shades and not really drawing or sketching them. Once I finish shading and when I'm happy with its shape, I use my white eraser pencil to create those highlights wherever the light is falling upon. I just try to remove the excess graphite from those areas. Moving on to the cheeks. When you have larger areas to shade, go for blending stump or brush. Make sure your strokes are not back and forth when you're using stump or brush. You just have to glide them from left to right and not do the action of back and forth. The cheeks need a lot of contouring shading. This can be achieved well using stumps as base layer, and once you're done with the base layer, you can add more layers to them by using an HB or 2B pencils. So once you are done identifying the areas of highlights and shadows, just go about shading them and highlighting the highlights with the white eraser pencil or any other eraser such as Mono Zero eraser or any electronic erasers. So in my reference picture, the left cheek had a lot of shadows and the light was coming from the right side. So I'm not making a lot of darker tones on the right cheek and keeping it really minimal. While using mechanical pencil, you can use one side of the lid for making shadows or smoother lines like for the skin, and rotate the pencil to the other side of the lid for making hard or dark lines such as hair. You can sketch an entire portrait with just mechanical pencils of lids HB, 2B and 4B. Don't forget to get those blemishes, marks, dark spots and wrinkles on your portrait, as no skin is really flawless and you gotta make them to have a real like portrait. Create pores using dark circles and filling in with white space using pencil eraser. Kneaded eraser can be used to get nice highlights too. It can mainly be used in places where you want really smooth highlights and not strong line strokes which comes out of a pencil eraser. I link in all the supplies that I used for this portrait in the description box below. Moving on to the lips. First, I pick my HB pencil and fill in all the places where there is no highlight that's gonna come up, and I use my brush to smudge it out. Once I'm done with it, I use my 2B pencil to make those lines and wrinkles that is there on the lips. Then I pick my 4B pencil to darken all the lines. So here I'm creating three different shades, that is HB, 2B and 4B. And also I'm going to create highlights using the Mono Zero eraser. I block the shadow area with darker shade pencil on the right side. And once I'm done with it, I'm going about with my Mono Zero eraser and creating those highlights. Make sure to not go harder on the paper, because the hard lines damages the paper and you will not be able to add layers thereafter. So it's really important to go really smooth on the paper and make just feather touch where there is no really hard shadows. I'm concentrating more on the lines and the shadows where the wrinkles of the lips are coming upon. Make the edges of the lips really dark. I'm going on adding layers of 2B and 4B and also gradually creating all those highlights with my Mono Zero eraser. The area under the lower lip is really dark, but make sure that you don't go about hard lines over there. There should be a transition between the lower lip and the chin. I'm making it on a gradient effect. I'm using charcoal pencil to fill in the gaps between the teeth. This particular area needs to be really dark. The reason I'm using charcoal pencil here is that the graphite pencils are not as dark as the charcoal pencils. So this place needs to be really dark, as it is inside and the teeth is outside. And spreading the charcoal using the stumps. Here again, the teeth is similar to the white part of the eye. It has a little shadow and you should never leave it blank. You should always add those little shadows on the teeth to make it look some in the front and some go at the back. When I'm happy with the lips, I'm just going at the chin. I'm just concentrating more on the shadows and just using my HB pencil to darken all the areas where I'm getting the shadow. Again, using a very soft brush to spread it out evenly to get that skin texture. Repeating the process on the other cheek, but here I'm not stressing a lot and I'm making it really less toned, as the shadow is more on the left side and less on the right side. Moving on to the forehead and hair, I'm repeating the process onto the forehead. I'm just using the stump to cover up the area on the forehead, and I'm using charcoal for the hair. I'm blocking in all the shadows that are on the hair and going about shading them using a charcoal pencil. Once I've covered the shadows, I'm just blending them with the blending stump to spread it to the close by strands. You don't have to concentrate on each and every strand, just by blocking in all the shadows and just keep spreading using the brushes. Add second layer of shadows once you have spread out using the stumps. By doing this, you're giving the hair more dimension to it and eliminating all the white space, giving it more natural look. Repeat the process for the entire hair, block in all the shadowed area and blend it with the blending stump and layer it over again and then spread it using the brush. For blonde hair, again, don't leave the space white. There should be a minimal shading everywhere. The blonde place should also have the basic shade of HB. Here you can make use of mechanical pencil, as they are very precise, and you can make specific strands, such as a strand of hair falling onto the forehead and those tiny hair strands behind the ears. Once you are done with the hair, move on to the ears. Keep the shading really minimal when it comes to ears. Block in all the deep areas where it is really shadowed and less light areas, and go about shading them. Again, I'm not going to leave any white space without any graphite on even ears, because white area without any shades look really bad. As long as it is not a complete highlight or it is a too much of white light falling upon that place, make sure that you give a basic shade to every places on the sketch. Repeat the same for the other eye. While drawing jewelry, again I'm going for charcoal pencil here, because I want the earrings to be really dark and not a graphite shade, and graphite cannot be darkened more than a specific value. So here, as per the reference picture, the earrings were really darker from the remaining area of the portrait. So I chose charcoal pencils over graphite and just spread it around using the blending stumps. I'm repeating the process for the other ear. I can see a lot of highlights on the earrings, so I'm leaving them white. Once I'm done with the jewelry, I'm moving on to the neck part. I'm using the same charcoal pencil and darkening the dress. I'm shading the shoulders and spreading out using my brush. I'm just adding in more layers to create that shadow, making it look more real. I'm adding a lot of layers and then moving to the neck. I'm just making the shadows and highlights similarly. I'm trying to spread out the graphite evenly throughout using the brush and leaving some space for the highlights. don't forget to make those marks on the neck. All these minute information gives a real nice finishing. So that's all guys, this is how it looks. The final output is here. I've completed sketching the entire portrait. If you enjoyed this video, please click on the like button and do share it with your friends.